the Suzuki Eiger came into this test with some mighty big shoes to fill. After all, we rated the Vinson 500 as the best 500cc sport utility machine last year. And we rated the Suzuki Ozark the best 250cc lightweight utility. And we rated the Racy LTZ 400 the best sport quad. But somehow, the Eiger just never seemed to show up on our best of radar. I guess we need to check the radar. You know, perhaps we were just misled because the Eiger may just be a bit homely, or at least in the nose department. You know, it just seems to stick out a little too far, giving an otherwise good design a bit of a Cyrano de Bergerac complex. But let's try to overlook that for a minute and focus on the specs. The Suzuki Eiger is powered by a simple, air-cooled 376cc four-stroke engine. It can be had with either a 5-speed auto-clutch tranny or, as our test unit, with a CVT automatic. This tranny shifts from the right top of the tank and has high, low ranges, neutral, and reverse. There's a two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive lever on the right side of the handlebar that rotates to select your traction preference. The wheelbase is a fairly long 50 inches, and the seat height the rather low 32.7 inches. Suzuki lists the dry weight as 590 pounds, which puts it in the less than normal range for a 400 class ATV. Fuel capacity is 4 gallons, and the ground clearance is 9.3 inches. The front suspension is dual A-arms with adjustable shocks and 6.7 inches of travel. And the rear is a single swing arm with dual adjustable shocks that also provide 6.7 inches of travel. The brakes are dual discs up front and a single drum in the rear. Gauges consist of an analog speedometer, odometer, and trip odometer. Now, the first thing you notice is that although the shifter is basically on the right, the fact that it's located more of a central location on the tank, it works as easily as if it were on the left. The gate is straightforward, with a push button needed to shift either into reverse or out of neutral. The engine provides just about as much power as any 400 class machine, and it delivers it very smoothly and without a lot of mechanical clatter. The CVT transmission engages quickly and quietly as well, with no belt slip or whine noticeable. And the front differential provides good traction when the going gets extreme, and a low seat height and lightweight give the Eiger rider enough confidence to get in trouble, perhaps. Now, that same smoothness of operation from the engine and the transmission, along with a soft and comfortable seat, make the Eiger a very nice ATV to just cruise around on as well. Then, as the trail speed increases, the suspension geometry and the well-dampened shocks soak up the whoops with confidence. There's only a slight amount of engine buzz that's transmitted through the seat cushion to the rider. The brakes provide decent stopping power and excellent feel, whether using the handlebar levers or the foot pedal. You know, today, as many new ATVs use the single lever braking system, they also tend to overlook the value of a good foot pedal. The Suzuki offers the perfect braking setup, a good lever for the rear brakes on the left handlebar, and a good lever for the front brakes on the right handlebar, and a usable foot pedal on the right floorboard, just like we're used to on motorcycles. Now, perhaps one of the most noticeable features we found on the Eiger was actually the overall feel of the machine. The switches all worked smoothly, the steering was precise and provided just the right amount of feedback without ever fighting back over every rut. The front tracked straight and true regardless of trail conditions. And of course, those brakes work just as they should, with good power and good feel. And the racks on the Eiger are great examples of just how easy to use those old-fashioned, straightforward steel tubing racks are. Boxes and bags fit on without fuss, or the anger that's found in trying to wind a strap through a small little slot in a spot where the manufacturer thought you'd like it to be. Plus, they're raised above the plastic bodywork just high enough to clean under it. Just one more example of a well-thought-out design. All the little things work. The good? Great ergonomics, great performance, wonderful price. The bad? Homely looks with too much nose overhang. The bottom line? You'd be hard-pressed to find more four-wheel drive ATV for your money.